In this webcast, I'll explain how a molecule uses the energy absorbed from light to promote a photochemical reaction. Upon excitation, a reactant is in a new electron configuration, and in that new electron configuration, it's governed by a new potential energy surface. It can move along that surface all the way to the product, still in the excited state. In the excited state, that product can emit a photon and jump down to a ground state surface of a new product that's shown here. This process, where only the excited state surface is involved, is what's known as the adiabatic photoreaction. To summarize, then, the adiabatic photoreaction involves absorption of light by the reactant to generate the excited state electron configuration, and then by the normal thermal motions that are imparted to that excited state molecule, it travels along to the excited state of the product, emitting a photon and generating the final product. This process, the adiabatic photoreaction, is what's responsible for most chemiluminescent processes. A more common photochemical process is what's known as the diabatic photoreaction, in which both the excited state potential energy surface and the ground state potential energy surface are involved. Here's how that happens. The reactant absorbs a photon of light and changes into that excited state electron configuration. It begins to travel along the excited state surface until the geometry matches a geometry that is also found on the ground state potential energy surface. This position is what's known as a conical intersection. And at that point, it's possible for the molecule to transfer over to the ground state surface, at which point it can continue along in the normal way using thermal motion to promote the reaction leading to the product. So in the diabatic photoreaction, the molecule absorbs light, changes to the excited state configuration, and then at some point crosses back over to the ground state and generates the product in its ground state. What's important to realize about the diabatic reaction is that the molecule uses the energy of light in order to hop over this initial thermal barrier and set the wheels in motion to carry out the subsequent chemical reaction.